Welcome back, learners. Now we are going to start the second part of the concept of financial management. And in this part, we will learn what are the different sources of finance available in the capital market, what is the concept of fixed capital, what is the concept of working capital, and what are the factors which determines the component of fixed capital and working capital in an organization. So now we are going to start with the concept of sources of finance. Now, sources of finance, this we have discussed into our earlier classes, that in investment decision, the capital is required for the purpose of investments, whether it is a short term investment or whether it is a long term investment. So, as per the investment decision criteria, there is two types of capital required by a business, and these two broad heads are known as fixed capital, and the second broad head is known as the working capital. Now you can correlate this concept with your earlier concept which we have discussed in the previous sessions, that in investment decision we have two types of investment, long term investment decisions and short term investment decision. So for facilitating the long term investment decisions, we need fixed capital, we can say in that way, and for facilitating the short term investment decision, we should have working capital in our hand. Now, important thing, every kind of business, whether it is big, medium or small, needs these two type of capital for facilitating its operations and for the purpose of carrying out its day-to-day activities. What is the meaning of fixed capital? So, what is the use of fixed capital we are discussing? Fixed capital is basically relates with the concept of long-term funds which are required by a firm to create the production facilities in an organization, and these production facilities can be established only through purchase of fixed assets. Now, what is fixed assets? Plant, machinery, land, building, furniture, etc., etc. Now, if we talk about the investment in these assets, represents that part of firm's capital which is blocked on permanent or fixed basis, and therefore it is called the fixed capital. Why we are saying that this is known as the fixed capital? Because the once you made the investment, this investment is blocked for a long period of time, and therefore it is known as the fixed capital. Now, this is the concept of fixed capital. Now, I hope you understand. Now, we are coming on to the second part, and the second part is known as the working capital. So, what is working capital? Because funds are also needed for short term purposes, like for the purchase of raw material, for the payment of wages and other day-to-day expenses. So, for facilitating all these activities in an organization, the capital which is needed by the firm is known as working capital. So, here the main emphasis is on the concept of working. So, we can make a very simple explanation that you can easily learn this concept. Here we are discussing about the routine working. So, for routine working, this working capital is required, and as we all know, which we have discussed in the starting, it is the provision of money at the time when it is required. So, these are basically the two financing facilities which an organization has to arrange at any cost. As we have discussed, any type of organization, whether it is big, medium or small, it needs both these type of capital to carry on its operation and to achieve their targets. Now, I hope this concept is clear. Fixed capital, working capital. Now, we are coming on to the second part of the same chapter, that what is the concept of factors affecting the fixed capital. Now, what are the factors affecting the fixed capital? If we talk about that, how should you determine that what is fixed capital, or what should be the appropriate component an organization should have in terms of fixed capital? Now, this is an important part, because nature of every firm is different, and when the nature is different, the requirement of fixed capital and the requirement of working capital would also be different. Now, first of all, we will discuss that what are the factors which affect the fixed capital component in an organization. Now, we are going to start. The first factor is nature of business. Now, if we talk about the nature of business, now there are manufacturing sector we have, and we have service sector. So in which sector your firm is operating, it depends the requirement of fixed capital. For example, if a firm is operating in a manufacturing sector, then it will have to require a large proportion of fixed capital. And if a firm is operating in a service sector, then it will require a less amount of working capital. Now, I am not saying these words because you will have to learn. Think logically. If an organization is operating in a manufacturing sector, it will require a huge amount of capital to be invested in plant, machinery, equipments, furniture, and other. So all this require a huge amount of capital, which is to be blocked in these permanent assets. Now, if we talk about the service sector, there is absence of inventory, there is absence of debtors, there is absence of plant, there is absence of machinery, there is absence of equipment. So all these big permanent assets are not required into the service sector, and therefore the requirement of fixed capital in service sector is less in comparison of a manufacturing sector. Now we are coming on to the second factor which affects the fixed capital requirement, and that is of type of products. Now if we talk about the type of products, there are two type of products, like complex products and simple products. Now this is not a tough term. What is simple products? We can say is the FMCG items like soap, oil, toothpaste, toothbrush, all these are comes into the FMCG items, so we can say them simple products. And now what are the complex products? You can have cement, steel, textiles, ship manufacturing or plane manufacturing, etc. So now I hope you understand that the organization, if it is producing a complicated product like cement, steel, textiles, it will require a good deal of big equipments, and therefore the requirement of fixed capital would be high in comparison of that organization which is producing the simple products like FMCG items. So now this is the second part of type of products. Now we are coming on to the third part, size of business. This is again a very simple part, say simple factor. We can simply say larger the size of business, larger will be the requirement of fixed capital, and vice versa. If the size or scale of business of operations is very huge in amount, then the requirements of the fixed capital would be high. And if the size of the business is not too big, it is medium or it is small in size like MSMEs, so the requirements of fixed capital would be low. Three points are clear. Fourth one is coming, process of production. Now process of production is basically connected with the second part, type of product. How it is connected? If the process of production is lengthy, for example, if a product is passes through a different processes of manufacturing, then definitely the process of production becomes lengthy, and this lengthy requires automation process. We can have a look. Automatic production, and second we have manual production. Now if an organization is following the automatic production technology, then it requires a huge equipment, machines and other details, and therefore we can say that in automatic productive technology, organization requires a huge amount of permanent capital to be invested into the firm. And if a firm is following the manual production technology, means most of the production depends on the labor work, and therefore there is no such big need of big machines, big equipments, big material, etc. And therefore the need of the fixed capital would be low. So this is the fourth point. Now coming on to the final point, method of acquiring the fixed assets. Now there are two methods of acquiring the fixed assets. One method is method of acquiring fixed assets. Now one method is cash method, and second method we have lease method. Now leasing is a different term which we generally use in terms of accounting. For the sake of convenience, we can say that when we take something on rent, it comes under the concept of lease. It becomes a concept of leasing. So I hope this part is clear, that when an organization is not using the concept of leasing, it is using the concept of buying it. For example, if a particular machine is required for the purpose of production of a certain kind of a finished product, and that machine, if an organization is buying it, then it is using this method. And if you are using this method, your fixed capital requirement would be high. But if an organization is not in a mood to buy it, but to take it on the rent, means that organization is following the leasing method for acquiring that machine, then it means its requirement of the fixed capital would be low. And therefore, we conclude all these points. First point, we have discussed nature of business. As we know, manufacturing, servicing, manufacturing industry, service industry. Second, we have discussed type of product, simple products, complicated products. Third, we have discussed size of business, larger the size, larger the requirements of fixed capital, and vice versa. Fourth, we have discussed process of production, two types of process of production, automated and manual. Or if you are following automated technology, requirements of fixed capital would be high, and vice versa. And fifth and final point is method of acquiring the fixed assets. If the method is on cash basis, organization requires large amount of fixed capital, and if an organization is using leasing method, it requires less amount of fixed capital. So with this, it is the end of fixed capital. Now we are started the second aspect of the capital needed by the organization, and that aspect is known as working capital. So we have already discussed that what is working capital. We cannot ignore the importance of working capital. We can take very simple example. That, for example, organization purchases the machine in 50 lakh rupees. Now, this is the example of fixed capital. But for running that machine, organization requires fuel to insert into it. Now, for the purpose of buying the diesel, now for the purpose of buying the fuel from the market, the capital which the organization requires is known as working capital, so that the machine can be put into the operation. And therefore, organization again puts a lot of emphasis, puts a lot of efforts on acquiring the working capital, so that the working of the organization can be maintained or can be run in a smooth way. If we want to define in a very simple term, working capital represents the amount of funds invested in current assets. Learn the definition which we have discussed in our earlier session, short-term investment decisions. So, short-term investment decisions are basically related here, or basically depicted here with the term current assets. So this is the other way of defining the working capital. Concept should be clear that working capital represents the amount of funds invested in current assets. Now, example of current asset like debtors, stock in trade, cash required for meeting day-to-day expenses, for the purpose of paying wages or salaries to the workers, and for the purpose of payment of dues to their creditors. So this is the concept of working capital. Now, how many types of working capital are there? So there are two types of working capital: permanent working capital and temporary working capital. Permanent working capital is also known as fixed working capital, and temporary working capital is also known as variable working capital. Now, if we want to have a look that what is permanent, what is temporary, what aspect we are focusing into the working capital, there is a very simple graph for the permanent and variable working capital. We can take two axes. On x axis we have taken time, on y axis we have taken amount. So now I am drawing two lines, you can have a look. Can I say that this is the permanent working capital? Because you can have a look, time is changing, but the amount of working capital is not changing. So this is known as permanent, means which is maintained by the firm 24/7. That capital is known as permanent working capital. Organization never allow to fall this label down. Now coming on to the second, temporary working capital. So any fluctuations in the working capital over and above the permanent working capital is known as temporary or variable working capital. We can also draw. This is the fluctuating line, and that fluctuating line is representing temporary working capital, and this fixed line is known as permanent working capital. You can have a look. This line is variable in nature. It varies at every point of time. It is not fixed. That's why it is also known as variable working capital. But this line always remains fixed. Time is changing. We have taken the time onto the x-axis. Time is changing, but the amount of working capital is not changing. So that is why there are two concepts we should clearly know, that not only the concept of working capital, but we should clearly know that what is the amount, what is the concept of permanent working capital, and what is the concept of variable working capital. Now again, proceeding to the working capital cycle. What is working capital cycle? Because working capital cycle is the concept through which we came to know that what is the speed of generating the cash in an organization. We are discussing about the working capital cycle. Now this is again the important concept, because working capital cycle determines that what is the speed of generating the cash in an organization. Until and unless we should understand the concept of working capital cycle, we are not able to understand that what is the appropriate need of working capital into an organization, because neither the shortage of working capital should be there nor the excess of working capital should be there, and therefore we take into consideration this cycle. So this cycle is basically known as working capital cycle. So this cycle starts with raw material. Whenever a manufacturer starts its production, it have raw material into their hands. This raw material is converted into an intermediary stage, which is known as work in progress. In simple, we call it WIP. This WIP has been converted into the finished product. Now, this finished product is ready to sell in the market. This finished product now come into the market for the purpose of sales. Now, it is not possible that an organization should sell all its products in cash basis, and therefore whenever there is a credit basis of sales, as per the terms of accounts, there is a creation of debtors. So debtors means those parties to whom the organization has sold the goods on credit basis. So these are the sales. From the sales, if the sales is made on credit basis, we have the debtors, and from the debtors you collect the cash, and when you have cash in your hand, you comes again to this part. You buy the raw material, it again converts into the WIP, then finished product, then sales, then debtors, then cash, and this cycle keeps on moving, keeps on moving, keeps on moving. So the important idea behind this cycle is that what should be the speed of this cycle? Should it be slow or should it be accelerated? The answer is the speed of this cycle should be accelerated. As soon as the speed of this cycle is accelerated, organization completely satisfies its working capital requirements. And if the speed of this cycle becomes slow, your cash collection speed would be slow, and therefore your dependency over the external market for the generation of working capital would be high, because you are not going to generate the working capital from your own activities. Why? Because your working capital cycle is slow. How it can be slow? For example, you are converting the raw material work in progress very late. You are again converting the WIP into the finished product very late. And you are again making the sales very late. Then credit sales, then debtors. And now again you are showing your laziness in collecting the cash from the debtors. So unnecessarily, this cycle becomes completed, for example, in 60 days, which might be completed in 40 days. So this is the logic behind the working capital cycle. So I hope the idea is clear that why we are studying this, because the speed of this cycle should be accelerated, and therefore organization puts a lot of emphasis on the speed of the cycle, that how it can be accelerated. Now this we have discussed in the working capital. Three things we have discussed: what is the concept of working capital, how many types of working capital are there, and then we have discussed working capital cycle. Now coming on to the last part of the working capital, that what are the factors which determines the working capital requirements. Means, how would you know that this is the requirement of working capital of this firm? How you came to know? Because this is a very not a simple task. So, this requires a meticulous study that what are the factors which affect the working capital requirements of a firm. So, again the first factor is coming nature of business. As we have discussed in the fixed capital requirement, nature of business. Now, in nature of business, again there are two categories we have divided. We have manufacturing sector and we have service sector. Now, you can have a look. In manufacturing sector, an organization requires a large amount of working capital. Why large amount of working capital? Why I am saying? Because in manufacturing sector, two most important assets are present, like inventory and debtors. You should have inventory because you are in a manufacturing sector. So, as per the, I am discussing with you the result of a research study that there is a research conducted in India on 36 major industries, and the outcome of that research was that 70 paise in a rupee of a manufacturing firm are blocked into its inventory. Can you believe 70 paise of a rupee means 70% of the capital of a manufacturing firm is blocked into its inventory, and therefore the working capital requirements of a manufacturing firm is high. Second asset which we have discussed, after inventory there is debtors, because it is not possible for the firm to sell all its goods in cash basis only. So, therefore, debtors is also there in business, in manufacturing business. So, inventory and debtors when high, then your cash is blocked in the form of inventory and debtors, and therefore, your working capital requirements would be high. Now, have a look that inventory and debtors both are absent in service sector. In service sector, there is no provision of making the credit sales. So, there is absence of debtors. Now, in service sector, there is also no manufacturing, and therefore, there is no use of inventory. So, again, there is absence of stock inventory, and therefore, we can say that the working capital requirements in a service sector is low in comparison of manufacturing sector. Second point, size of business, or we can say the scale of operations. If the size of business is big, this is a very simple point. If the scale of operations is very big, the working capital requirements would be high, and vice versa. Larger the size, larger will be the requirements. Lower the size, lower will be the requirements. This is a very simple point. This we have also discussed into the fixed capital requirements. Now, third point, we are coming, length of production cycle. Now, yes, this is the important one. What is the length of production cycle? It means that what is the speed of converting the raw material into the finished product. So, if the speed of converting the raw material into the finished product is lengthy, then organization requires a large amount of working capital. We can have a look that if raw material you are converting in 20 days from WIP, and WIP is converted into finished product in 25 days. So, what is the length? 45 days. Now, your competitor completes this first phase in 15 days and second phase in 20 days. So, now the length of production cycle of your competitor is only 35 days. So, now very simple that your working capital requirements would be high, because you are late producing the product, you will going to late make the sales, then you will going to have the late cash collection, and then you have raw material into your hand. So, if the length is long, your working capital requirements would be high. If the length of production cycle is short, you are immediately converting the raw material into the finished product, your working capital requirements would be low. I hope this point is clear. Fourth point, we are discussing now seasonal variations, or we can say the fluctuations. India is a country of festivals. We all know that. So, as we know, as per the season, your working capital requirements would be high. If we talk about the winter season, there is no requirement of AC, refrigerators and all. So, all those firms which are producing the equipments related to AC, electricity and all, their working capital requirements would be low. But the firms which are producing woolen cloths, which are producing heaters, which are producing other things which are suitable to the winter season, their working capital requirements would be high because the season favors the business. So this is the fourth point. Fifth, we are coming rate of stock turnover. In turnover, the simple meaning of turnover is sales. If the rate of stock selling is high, organization will require less working capital. Why less working capital? Because the organization is selling its stock at a very fast speed and the flow of cash into the organization is very good and smooth. And if this rate of stock turnover becomes low, then what will happen? Your working capital requirements would be high because you are not able to sell your stock into the market in a considerable speed. And where you are not able to sell your stock, then your working capital requirements would be high because you do not have enough cash in your hands and you will have to maintain all your workings. So this is the fifth point. Now we are coming on to the sixth, credit policy. If an organization is following the strict credit policy, two types of credit policy we have, strict and liberal. If an organization is having the strict credit policy, then the working capital requirements would be low because most of the times you do not prefer to sell your goods on credit basis. Means 90% sales in cash, for example, 10% in credit. So 90% cash flow is good, so you require less working capital. And if an organization is following liberal, means 90% credit, 10% sales, it means you require high amount of working capital because most of your fund have been blocked into the debtors. Last point, inflation. If the inflation is high, organization requires large amount of working capital. If inflation is normal, then organization will require less amount of working capital. Now, we can summarize our part 2. In this part 2, we have discussed what are the different sources of finance available in the capital market. What is the concept of fixed capital we have discussed? What is the concept of working capital? What is working capital cycle? What is the types, different types of working capital? And last topic which we have discussed, last but not the least, because this is the important one, factors determining the fixed capital and the working capital requirements. So with this, it is the end of session 2. I hope this session would be enjoyable to all of you and we will meet again. Till then, thank you.